Now, just a quick recap. How bilirubin is excreted from body? Bilirubin is produced due to destruction of RBCs and catabolism of hemoglobin. In blood, it is in bound form, that is bound to albumin. Then in liver, it enters into hepatocyte, where it is conjugated to glucuronic acid. And finally, it is excreted into the bile canaliculi. From there, it reaches the small intestine. Once this conjugated bilirubin reaches the small intestine, it is acted by microbes of the gut, which produce a compound from that known as urobilinogen. Now, 80% of this urobilinogen is excreted into the feces, right? While 20% is reabsorbed into the blood, and it again enters to the liver, and further it is excreted into the bile. This is known as enterohepatic circulation. But some amount of it also enters into the kidney and it is excreted from the kidney. Plus, this urobilinogen in feces also gets reduced to a compound known as urobilin, which gives the brown color to the feces. Now, jaundice is yellowish discoloration of tissues due to accumulation of excess bilirubin. Now, when can this bilirubin accumulate? So, if you know this excretion mechanism of bilirubin, you can easily tell when can bilirubin accumulate. So, either there is increased destruction of RBCs leading to increased production of bilirubin, or there can be dysfunctional liver which interferes with uptake, conjugation and excretion of conjugated bilirubin. Third, there can be obstruction of the bile duct, so that it reaches to the bile, but however it cannot enter into the small intestine and excrete it. Now, before we deal with basics of jaundice, you should remember few things. That unconjugated bilirubin, that means the bilirubin which is present in blood bound to albumin, is water insoluble. Thus, it cannot appear in urine. Second, conjugated bilirubin, it is water soluble and mostly it is excreted in stools. But it can be excreted in urine also because it is water soluble. Third, the urobilinogen, which is formed in a small intestine, it is excreted into the feces. However, some amount of it is reabsorbed and enters into urine also. Now, if we can determine the different types of bilirubin and the concentration of urobilinogen in feces and urine, we can differentiate between these causes of jaundice, whether it is due to increased breakdown of RBCs or due to liver problem or due to obstruction of bile duct. Now, depending on where the problem is occurring, there are different names of this jaundice. So, if it occurs before the hepatocyte, that means at the level of destruction of RBCs, it is known as prehepatic jaundice or hemolytic jaundice. If the problem is obstruction of bile duct, it is known as posthepatic jaundice or obstructive jaundice. If hepatocytes are not able to perform their function, there is derangement of liver function, then it is known as hepatic jaundice. Let us now determine the features of different types of jaundice. In hemolytic jaundice, there is excess breakdown of RBCs and excess production of bilirubin. However, liver is able to perform its function properly. So, what will happen with more and more formation of bilirubin? There will be more and more uptake, more and more formation of conjugated bilirubin and its excretion into the bile and in the small intestine. Thus, there will be more formation of urobilinogen, right? You know that 20% of it is reabsorbed into the blood and enters back into the liver. So, there will be recirculation of this urobilinogen and there will be excretion into the kidney also. But you see, even if liver is able to perform more function, it is not able to cope up with excess production of bilirubin. That means there will be accumulation of this unconjugated bilirubin in blood. So, what will be the features if we determine all these concentrations? We'll have increased unconjugated bilirubin, increased urobilinogen in feces, and increased urobilinogen in urine, right? But bilirubin itself will not appear in urine. It is the end product, urobilinogen, which will appear in urine. So what will happen in obstructive jaundice where there is obstruction to bile duct? You see, this conjugated bilirubin will be excreted in bile but cannot pass into the small intestine. So what happens that eventually it regurgitates back into the blood. So this conjugated bilirubin starts appearing in blood, right? And urobilinogen will not form if there is complete obstruction of bile duct. Urobilinogen will not form in a small intestine and it won't be excreted in stools. Similarly, urobilinogen will not be excreted in kidney because if it is not formed, it does not get absorbed and gets excreted in kidney. So the features which you will get is increased conjugated bilirubin. It is different from hemolytic where you got increased unconjugated bilirubin. Here it is increased in conjugated bilirubin in blood. Then decrease in urobilinogen in feces and decreased urobilinogen in urine. But one more thing will happen. You remember this conjugated bilirubin is water soluble and thus it can be excreted in urine. So there will be deep yellow color of the urine seen in this kind of jaundice. But the color of feces which is provided by urobilin will be lost. So here you will get clay colored stool, right? Now let us see third type, that is hepatic jaundice. So in hepatic jaundice, there will be problem in all, like uptake of bilirubin, conjugation of bilirubin and also excretion of bilirubin. Plus, there may be some obstruction of these small bile canaliculi because they are present just nearby the hepatocytes, right? So what happens that since there is problem in uptake, this unconjugated bilirubin will increase in blood and whatever is entering, that is, it is becoming conjugated. All hepatic function will not be lost suddenly. So some amount of bilirubin is being conjugated, but it is not being excreted. So this conjugated bilirubin will accumulate in the hepatocytes and will back diffuse into the blood. So there is increase in unconjugated bilirubin as well as increase in conjugated bilirubin. And urobilinogen will decrease in feces. It will also decrease in urine. Plus, this conjugated bilirubin will also appear in urine. So, what will be the features? There will be increase in unconjugated bilirubin. There will be increase in conjugated bilirubin in blood. The conjugated bilirubin will be excreted in urine. So, there will be presence of bilirubin in urine. Then, there will be decrease of urobilinogen in feces and there will be decrease of urobilinogen in urine. Let us summarize. In hemolytic jaundice, increased bilirubin in blood, right? Conjugated bilirubin will not be there because conjugated bilirubin is the one which is excreted in urine. So this will also be absent because of increased formation of urobilinogen in intestine. There will be increased urobilinogen in feces and some amount of it is also excreted in urine. So this will also increase. Oh, let us first see obstructive jaundice where unconjugated bilirubin will be normal. Conjugated bilirubin will start appearing in blood because of a regurgitation of conjugated bilirubin. So this will be high. Conjugated bilirubin also appears in urine. So it will be present in urine. But since there is obstruction of bile duct, bilirubin does not go into the small intestine. So, the urobilinogen in feces will not be there. Therefore, it will also not be there in urine. Hepatic jaundice has features of both hemolytic and obstructive jaundice. Since unconjugated bilirubin is not being taken up by liver, it will increase. Plus, since there will be minor obstruction of bile canaliculi, conjugated bilirubin will also accumulate in hepatocytes and regurgitate. So that will also increase in blood. This conjugated bilirubin will start appearing in urine, right? But there will be less urobilinogen in urine and less urobilinogen in feces because of obstruction of bile ducts. So by combination of all these features, you can actually determine the type of jaundice.